What's up, guys? Your boys are back. I'm Ryan, my man, George.
Yeah, man, what's shaking, guys? How y'all living? Shout out to the Free Thinkers.
So you know what I'm saying? Lil Wayne, man. Lil Wayne dropped a new album, man, called Funeral.
Yeah.
Number one, I didn't hear, either one of us didn't know about this album was dropping immediately.
You know what I'm saying? A couple people in our personal life gave us sort of a heads up.
Right.
You know what I mean? Somebody that we know actually really, really likes this song, Harden, which is why we're going to do this song on the album. They were saying that he really went in on this one, though, because we've been critical.
Yeah.
we've been a lot more critical of Lil Wayne behind the scenes, to be real with you,
than
we have on camera. You know what I mean? So this dude that we know said Harden was the song that he wanted us to check out. It's probably not even remotely the most popular song because this dude's from the cloth. He knows the real shit. So a lot of times the real shit y'all don't want to be in. So shout out to our guy, man, that told us to do this one.
The only reason why we are critical with Lil Wayne is because we both believe that Wayne is slick. He's got very, very clever lines, and he always makes me laugh. And I'm like, you know what? That was super creative how he came up with that line. I always find myself saying that.
Yep.
All the time.
Absolutely.
Man. But I mean, I think sometimes, man, he'll come out with a song that I really, really like a lot, and then he'll come out with a couple other songs. I'm like, man, you know, it's just kind of all over the place to me, you know? But I like Wayne. That's why we're critical to Wayne.
Typically with Wayne, my issue is just, you know, it's lack of substance, and, you know, yeah, he'll have a lot of slick lines that we still gonna appreciate because we're hip hop heads.
Yeah.
You gotta appreciate just bars for the sake of bars. Don't get me wrong, but it just doesn't lead to some sort of like significant meaning of any sorts. You know what I mean? So
right.
It's that.
I get it.
It's the auto tune that he's using in songs. It's the when he's not using auto tune, sometimes the singing.
Yeah,
he's got this, and it just comes off sort of like with a lot of disharmony in his voice. And it just seems like many of his projects have just had a severe lack of direction. And what I would like from Lil Wayne is pretty much what I would like from a lot of artists is make a concise album, put like 10, 11 joints on there max, and focus on a specific sort of narrative and point that you're trying to make
with the project.
Make concepts, anything. You know what I mean? Just focus on that and make it relevant and consistent the entire way through. And I think these guys would still have the ability to create classic material that would stand the test of time.
Yeah.
But let's get into it though. Let's check it out. Let's see what Wayne has to offer on this one, man. Lil Wayne, Harden.
No cap.
Yeah. You can already tell.
That sample.
She let me and leave me. I gave her a reason. She don't want a reason. She don't want to see me.
You know, before we get into, I'm sorry, guys. Before we get into this, though, anytime I hear a soul sample, man, you know, and this is just purely a bias for me, man. And also, I just think when rappers hear soul samples, man, especially rappers urban that come from the cloth, when they hear that, they know that they got to go in. They know it calls for more emotion. It calls for more focus.
A level of seriousness.
Yeah, it just does. Mm-hmm. And that's why, I mean, I love the way soul samples sound, you know what I mean? Just sonically, but I love what they, you know, the mode that they put rappers
in. It's like purposeful.
Right? Yeah. But it puts rappers into a specific mode. Like, I gotta go in on this. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So far, so good. Let's get back to it.
No cap.
That sample's nasty too.
She let me and leave me. I gave her a reason. She don't want a reason. She don't want to see me. She don't believe me. I tell her it's cold. I'm already freezing. My heart ain't even beating. Just talk to the repeat. Put me on speaker. He told me to keep you. I know I ain't perfect. I shouldn't need to work on a nigga been working. I know you uncertain. You ride for me and I drive you crazy. And I know I've been swerving. I know you've been nervous. I know I've been reckless. And now you all heartless. And now it's all worthless. I don't deserve you. You don't deserve this. I turned a blessing into a burden. I'm really sorry. I know it don't fix it. A nigga been wishing it. I can reverse it. I know it don't help it. I know I look selfish and looks at deceiving. But you looking further and you looking past me. I'm just a has-been. How did this happen? What is occurring? What's your endurance? You acting like you never been in love. Like you just a tourist. Here was the purest till you got curious. You know that love don't come with assurance. I blame the jury. So put me on trial. They was sick in your smile. Now we just cured them. That got me furious. People that knew of us, tell me they sorry. I said I make two of them.
Okay. See? When Wayne. There's a lot that's going through my mind right now. Right? A, first and foremost, because typically I'm a lyrics first guy. You know what I mean? I think he's actually going in already. You know what I mean? He has a subject matter. It looks like he's talking about maybe a past love or a love that he's ruined with someone. So I'm not sure. We'll get into that in a little bit. So there's that, which I'm like, yes, you know what I'm saying? And it's kind of like what I predicted. It's just when you hear a soul sample, you know that the artist typically is going to be focused,
yeah,
and dig into sort of like a deep reservoir to really just give yeah, you give I you poetry. You know what I mean? That's what I'm getting with this. But I'm like, do I like the cadence? And did they really bring the beat to life? Because I love the sample itself.
Mm-hmm.
But did they really like, did they nail that? You know what I mean? So I'm just taking it all in. Brian, you can go ahead, man. I'm just.
No. I hear you, really, man. I don't want to
judge it yet.
He started this verse with saying, I know I ain't perfect. He said, I shouldn't need to work on it, but a nigga been working. So what that's telling me is he's trying to be better, but maybe it's just, you know, innately in him to do the things that he's doing, you know, and he just can't, you know, you just, it's almost like a struggle to break or a habit. Like a, like alcoholism and
all of that.
And mm-hmm. you know, if you're drug abuse, you're almost addicted to a certain extent. So but I agree with you with the cadence and the song, the way it sounds. I like the soulfulness in the sample, but I don't know, man. So far, I'm like, I don't know if it's grabbing me. But what he's saying is
Wayne
definitely
is barred up on this.
Yes,
I want to make that clear that he's barred up. But up here, I really love what he said in this sort of pre-chorus here, man. When he says she loves me. She love me or leave me. I gave her a reason. She doesn't want a reason. She don't want to believe me. She don't want to believe me. Whatever he said, right?
Yeah.
He said, I tell her it's cold. I'm already freezing. My heart ain't even beating. Just talk to the Reaper. He put me on speaker. He told me to keep you, which I think is really dope writing. So he's having this internal monologue with himself. And I feel like he knows that he's on a sort of a course for destruction, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
And he knows that he's close to seeing a Reaper. Like when he says talk to the Reaper, I think that he's saying, I know that I'm close to death. You know what I'm saying? And without this woman in my life, I'm going to perish, is what it sounds like. So that's how I'm taking a line. I thought that writing was really done. I think the writing in this has been great. I'm just kind of taking in a sample and in his voice in a beat as well. But I like what I'm hearing, though. You know what I'm saying? Bar-wise, I like what I'm hearing. Let's get back to it.
I'm just a has-been. How did this happen? What is occurring? What's your endurance? You acting like you never been in love, like you just a tourist. It was the purest till you that's got cool, curious. Man. You know that love don't come with assurance. I blame the jurors who put me on trial. They was sick in your smile. Now we just cured them. That got me furious. People that knew of us tell me they sorry. I said I make two of us. Wonder what ruined them. Wonder how beautiful you look at your wedding when I'm in my funeral. Goddamn.
See?
Yeah.
I'm sorry to stop it, but he had too many. I have to keep, like, it's just too many great lines in here. We have to stop the shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It just has to be stopped.
The way he ended this, man, when he said, wonder how beautiful you look at your wedding when I'm at my funeral, you know? It's almost like this is kind of like his last living testament, so to speak. Because he said, you act like you've never been in love before. Like you're just a tourist, you know what I mean?
Don't and lie to him.
It is, man. And it's almost like this person he doesn't want to let go, but she's already kind of moved on, so to speak. You know what I mean? And he doesn't want to let it go because he kind of squandered the opportunity with this person or what have you, you know? But I don't know, man.
But that line was interesting because he said, wonder how beautiful you look. You'll look at your wedding when I'm at my funeral. I don't know if he's trying to guilt trip this woman as well. That's what that comes off to me. Yeah. Like, it seems like it's a guilt trip. Like, you know, like when you've moved on and you've attained this happiness, I hope you're happy. You know what I mean? Because I'm going to be dead. Yeah. And that's the way it seems like he started this off when he said, I'll talk to the Reaper. You know, he put me on speaker and told me to keep you. Like, this woman was his last, she was keeping him alive.
Right.
Right? So it's like, without this woman, I'm essentially going to be dead. Like, she's going to move on from, you know, to happiness, and I'm going to be dead at this point.
Yeah.
So that's real heavy shit.
It is.
And I love how vulnerable and real this is, and I just love this. It's coherent.
Yeah.
It's not just a whole bunch of slick punchlines, which we know Wayne can do, but it's he's talking about a real situation between him and a past love, or maybe a current love, at least on his part.
Mm-hmm.
So, really dope, man.
And did she leave him? She said, he said, shit was the purest until you got curious.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Because he was fucking up. You know, Wayne is out here, man.
So, you know, love don't come with insurance, you know? I like that, man. I like that. But he's still slick in here, because I know you said he's not punchline, but he's still slick, though.
There you
and
go.
Clever, you know? So.
And I just think a lot of rappers, man, they use punchlines and these multi-syllables and all these tools.
As a cover-up.
It's cool. I like that too because it's all hip hop. I'm just saying, use those tools in a way that really guide you to a point, right? And tie those tools into sort of an underlying, you know, some type of underlying meaning. You know what I mean?
And, I feel you.
And when you do that, when you use those tools as well as Wayne does it, and you have some type of
magic.
Dude, it's amazing.
It's magic, yeah.
All right, let's get back to it.
You look at your wedding when I'm in my funeral. Goddamn. Let me leave me. Let me go my way. She let me and leave me. I gave her the reason. She don't want a reason. She don't want to see me. She don't want to believe me. I tell her it's cold. I'm already freezing. My heart ain't even beating. Just talk to the repeat. Put me on speaker. He told me to keep you. So I tried to call, but I couldn't reach you. You blocked my number. I feel like James Harden. You blocked my jumper. Goddamn. Who you loving? Who you wanna be fucking? Since it ain't me, just tell her, homie, eat lucky. I'm lonely for nothing. I'm staring at the phone and the button. The calls and the coming. I'm staring at the walls. I've been punching these walls. They mean nothing. I'm thinking about the ball. I've been fumbling when stars were abundant. This shit happening. All of a sudden, the tallest start flushing. Try to avoid the confront and enjoy the consumption. Where outside noise and seduction is harder
like
to
this.
Function.
Look what back the angels. Like this. If he can, if Wayne consistently rap like this,
yeah, he's incredible, dude.
Then he can silence the naysayers that say that he lacks depth. You know what I'm saying? Because this has a lot of depth in this. We're gonna talk about the bars, but that's just kind of the knock on Wayne, man. It's just like, what are you talking about, dude?
Mm-hmm.
What are you actually trying to say? You know what I mean? Not just a bunch of, you know, random great lines, but what are you saying?
I really like the line when he said, I'm thinking about the ball I've been fumbling when the stars were abundant, you know, and the shit happened and all of a sudden the toilet start flushing, you know.
I think
that was beautiful, man, because it's almost like her heart was the ball, you know what I mean? But the stars was abundant, meaning that he was a star.
Yep.
He had maybe women and all kinds of other things that was more important to her because it was abundance.
Yep.
You know, everything was abundant. Money
when
was abundant.
Everything was clicking.
Yeah, exactly.
When he was in top form, Lil Wayne on top of the world, and then he fumbled the ball. Yeah,
but then what happened? Yeah. Then the shit started coming. You know what I'm saying? And then what is she doing? All of a sudden the toilet starts flushing, you know? So she's flushing him out of her life, so to speak, is what I'm seeing. Like, yeah, you were, you know, the stars was abundant, but you still had a lot of shit and bullshit that came along with that.
Yep.
Now the shit starts to happen and then the shit starts rolling. The people that are really in your corner, which probably is her, now she's like, nah, I'm done. I'm done.
And now you realize.
I got to flush the shit out of my system.
Absolutely.
Type of thing.
Yep. Agreed. Well said. And now he's realizing that he didn't realize you had this pot of gold. But the way he said that, I want to touch on that because that's what made that. That's another layer why that shit hit so hard.
Yeah.
He said, I'm staring at the walls. I've been punching these walls. Didn't mean nothing. I'm thinking about the ball I've been fumbling when stars were abundant. Then shit happened and all of a sudden the toilet started flushing. Try to avoid the confronting, the joy, the consumption. With outside noise and seduction, it's harder to function. But it's depth in that.
And what
you know
saying.
What I'm saying?
Yep.
Try to avoid the confronting, the joy, and the consumption. With outside noise and seduction, it's harder to function.
Yeah.
That kind of ties into what we were saying.
Yep.
The seduction of the fame that, you know, with the drugs or whatever the case may be with Lil Wayne when he was on top of the world.
Yep. Exactly.
Everything in abundance with whether it's women, drugs, alcohol.
Money.
You know, anyway. You know what I'm saying? So I love the way the vulnerability in this, the reflection that he has in this song. How heartfelt this comes off.
Absolutely.
He's killing it to me.
When stars were abundant, this shit happened, and all of a sudden the toilet start flushing. Try to avoid the confront and enjoy the consumption. Where outside noise and seduction is harder to function. Look up at the angels, they hovering, they show me the light. They told me that I know that I'm wrong, but I don't know what's right. Goddamn.
That was hard too, man.
You must hate me. Let me leave me. She let me and leave me. I gave her a reason. She don't want a reason. She don't want to see me. She don't want to believe me. I tell her it's cold. I'm already freezing. My heart ain't even beating. Just talk to the repeat. Put me on speaker. He told me to keep you. So I tried to call, but I couldn't reach you. You blocked my number. I feel like James Harden. You blocked my jumper. Goddamn. Funeral.
Yeah, man, you know what? There's things that I can nitpick about that song. I can get nitpicky about some things in that, but I really, really, this is one of those circumstances, man, where the lyricism really just
outshines
some of those, you know, some of those parts of the song where I could live without. I don't know if I love the way he sounds in the chorus. I like the lyrics in the chorus. I just don't know if I like the way he's delivering it, but man. You know, and the beat is solid. It's not a bad beat either, and I love the soul sample in the beat, which kind of saves the beat, in my opinion, because the drums are okay in it. So, but the lyricism in this is some of the best lyricism I heard from Wayne
in a while,
in a very long time. This is dope lyrically, man. I thought he crushed this shit. But that line at the end, man, when he said, He said he looks up at the angels, they hovering. They show me the light. They told me that I know that I'm wrong, but I don't know what's right. You know what I'm saying? And that to me just, I don't know, man. I don't know Wayne personally. I don't know his situation. I'm just kind of going off of what I see in the public eye. When I look at Wayne and how he moves and some of the decisions that he makes, he seems to make, whether it's just the drug usage or whatever the case may be, it just seems like he's lost. Like, he doesn't know which direction to go. He doesn't know what moves he should be making at this stage in his life and his career. And it also, to me, is brought to life when I listen to his albums as well. Like, musically, it just seems like, what are you doing? Like,
that seems legitimate, is what you're saying.
Exactly.
Yeah, I got you.
It seems like he's lost. And I thought that was a very sort of introspective, real line. And maybe even a cry for help, you know what I mean, for Lil Wayne. So
could be. Could be, man. Well, I don't have much to add to that, dude. I think lyrically he destroyed it. I do enjoy some of the less introspective songs by Lil Wayne, to be honest with you.
We all do.
I think he's got a real clever pen when it comes to that. So I don't necessarily want him to stop doing that. But I do think, George, to your point, man, a more succinct, focused approach to an album that's thought-provoking, maybe less songs, you know, I think would do him some justice.
I think so.
You know what I mean? I do believe that. So so with that in mind, I'm going to give this song a thumbs up. But I do think, George, man, when you take what Wayne is great at lyrically and writing-wise and his cadence and punchlines, and you marriage that with a great production and subject matter, because I've seen him do that in other songs, man, I think you've got magic. I think you've got magic when it comes to that. And that's what I personally like about Wayne. When he does that, he's a dangerous man. In my opinion,
he's one of the coldest. when he's able to do that. And that's the thing, man. I just think that I don't know who's in these artists' camp. But when people say lyrically, you have to figure out like what that means. You know what I mean? If lyrically means I just want to punch you to death, then make a separate project, in my opinion.
Yeah, I got you.
You know what I mean? Make a cohesive, coherent project with a point that's conceptual and all this other stuff, or not even conceptual, just with meaning and substance, and then make a side project.
Yeah, I got you.
And punch us to death on that side project. But I think Wayne, it comes off, when I listen to his albums, it just comes off like he's scatterbrained when he has one song that means absolutely nothing, talking about shooting and killing people in one line and fucking a bitch in the second line, and then in the third line, I got money. It just, what are you talking about? So make a, if you just want to rap for the sake of rapping, try to maybe, I would say, separate that. Make a fucking project called Rappity Rap. Name that shit Rappity Rap, and just do your Rappity Rap shit. But when it comes to making, you know,
producing
an album, you know what I mean, have a coherent, that's just what it's always been. You know what I mean? Why does that have to change with hip hop? You know, so that's my opinion on it. But this, Wayne rap like this. Just rap like this. Now you don't have to have the same exact somber, like, soulful production, but just have the mindset that you went into rapping on this track. Just employ that mindset moving forward and make it concise. And then we could be
talking. We rocking.
We can bring Wayne back into that conversation with dudes that still murdering it. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know what the rest of the album sounds like. Give us some other suggestions for this album. You know, let us know what's hot on here. Maybe we'll try to get to another one from this project. Okay?
Cool. Yes, sir.
That's the end of the video, guys. If you enjoyed that, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I'm George. That's Ryan, Las Vegas.
We out.
We out.